We're going to determine the area under the function f of x equals 9 minus x squared on the closed interval from negative 3 to 3. Notice that negative 3 and 3 are the x-intercepts of the function, so we're trying to determine the area of the shaded region here. And because the function is continuous and non-negative on the given interval, we can set this up as a definite integral and then evaluate the definite integral using the fundamental theorem of calculus. So the area is going to be equal to the definite integral from negative 3 to 3 of 9 minus x squared integrated with respect to x. Now I should mention that because this region is symmetrical across the y-axis, meaning if we drew a line at x equals 0, the area on the left and the area on the right would be the same. We could integrate from 0 to 3 and then multiply the definite integral by 2. Meaning we could determine the area by doubling the integral from 0 to 3 of 9 minus x squared with respect to x. But I think we'll go ahead and leave it in the original form to determine the area. Now we'll find the antiderivative of 9 minus x squared. That would be 9x minus x cubed divided by 3. And now we'll evaluate this at the upper limit of integration, which is 3, and then evaluate this at x equals negative 3, and then determine the difference. And that will be the value of our definite integral, which in this case will be the area of the shaded region. So we'll first replace x with 3. So we'll have 9 times 3 minus 3 cubed divided by 3, minus the quantity 9 times negative 3 minus negative 3 cubed divided by 3. So here we'll have 27 minus, this will be 9, minus negative 27. This is going to be negative 9, but we're subtracting it, so it's plus 9. So we'll have 18 minus, this will be negative 18, which is equal to 36. So the area of the shaded region is 36 square units. Now I think you'll have to admit, this actually is pretty amazing. The area of this shaded region with this curved edge is exactly 36 square units, meaning 36 1-by-1 squares would fit perfectly inside the shaded region. And we can determine this area in a fairly straightforward process thanks to the fundamental theorem of calculus. We'll take a look at more examples in the next video.